John and Ida fell in love in Monroe, Utah. They drove up to the Manti Temple in a wagon with Ida's brother Aaron and Christina Rich. Both couples were married there, 14th of December, 1893. John was a member of the Monroe Cattle Company that was formed in 1915 on the Monroe Mountain. It was later dissolved in 1928. As that, the 116 acres came under the ownership of John William. John got real sick with cancer and it used up all of his assets, including the ranch. In order to keep the mountain property, he put it in his son's names. Here's a short summary of my younger life by my sister Laverde Hansen. Vaughn's sister Laverde wrote this about him.
Vaughn was born September 20, 1914, to John and Ida Julander in Monroe, Utah. Vaughn was the 12th child of 14. Vaughn was a beautiful baby. Everyone watched for him to wake up. His blue eyes just popped open and he was wide awake. The pupils of his eyes were so big they almost looked black. He was always good-natured and quiet. Vaughn and Grant used to ride stick horses before they could ride old Shorty. Every night after school, Vaughn and Boyd, as soon as they got in the house, they would start to wrestle. Later it was boxing. We had a boxing match or two every night before we went to bed. Mother always had lots of goodies, spud nuts, cookies, hot bread, meat, and vegetables. We had home eating every night during the winter, with big pans of popcorn with real butter and homemade candy.
From Vaughn's own history, he wrote, "I lived on a farm about 3 miles out of Monroe, Utah, all through my younger life. We moved into town when I was in junior high. I can remember driving a team of horses on a canvas-covered wagon to school and taking care of the horses before school. All the neighbors took turns driving. The wagon had a small coal and wood stove in the middle for heat. We always rode horses to town for showers and parties. I trained horses for people since I was 12 years old, till I reached about 50 years old. When I was 12 years old, I had a runaway with a team of horses on a mowing machine. I fell into the mower somehow and cut my leg. It took 18 stitches to sew it up, and they all broke, so I have quite a scar on my leg. I was in athletics in school, playing baseball, running, broad jumping, and all athletics. I attended all grades in Monroe, Utah, and graduated May 10, 1934. I attended Utah State Agricultural College for a quarter of a year and majored in forestry. My memories of college, it was cold. I went to Woodland, Utah when I was out of school to work on a farm for Ernest Knight for $30 a month and board. Next I went to Heber Valley, Utah to work for Lavelle Peterson, Lexi's husband, for $30 a month. Furl North lived down the road about a quarter of a mile, and she would go past where I was living quite often to see her friend, so we got acquainted that way and started going together. She was a brunette and weighed about 130 pounds. She was an outside girl and would sooner do farm work and garden than housework. She liked to ride a horse and liked all animals. She helped with the horses all the time. We went together about 9 months before we got engaged. We had some interesting dates. We rode horses to Deer Creek on a party once in a while.
I was born at home with a midwife as a doctor. I was 2 months premature. My parents were Azahel Albert North and Mary Stedman North. My birthday is November 17, 1917. I was very tiny and skinny. I was described as looking like a shriveled up old lady. I weighed only 3 pounds. I was weak and had to have so much care and attention, being fed with an eyedropper a few drops at a time, night and day. I was kept in a shoe box wrapped in cotton and kept on an oven door. I often wondered how my mother ever managed with me. It was a real struggle to keep me going until spring. I managed to survive all of the childhood diseases. However, I was left with a heart murmur by the age of 4 or 5 years, and because of this I was still much worried to my parents, always under the doctor's care. I took many tonics to build up my system and was kept somewhat restricted in my play. All my life I've loved the outdoors and enjoyed working and playing outside rather than indoors. At the age of 12 I had a nervous breakdown which caused many problems for quite a while. It took many days and nights getting my health back to normal and myself under control. I have had many experiences in my life when only God could have brought me through. Through His kindness and promptings I made it. One of these experiences was when I was playing near the barn. Suddenly something seemed to tell me to jump quick. I never heard a voice, but still received a strong prompting like a voice. I did jump quick. As I did so, the barn door, which was a huge one, came crashing down. It barely missed me, and would have crushed me for sure had it come down on me where I was standing. The winters as a child were very hard. We had lots of snow. We never used to see the fence, and very seldom a post, and it many times was 40 below zero. Many times I had frost-bitten feet and chilblains, which would cause my feet to itch so terrible and swell when they would get warm. We had kerosene lamps and brought water in the house in a bucket from the spring ditch that ran in front of the house. This water would have ice on it in the mornings. We heated bricks and wrapped them in paper to take to bed with us to keep warm. We had coal stoves and heated all the water to wash, bath, and washcloths. We bathed in a little round tub. My mother would heat the wash water and do all of her wash on the scrub board. She would be scrubbing when we went to school in the morning and still scrubbing when we came home at night. All of the farm work was done by teams of horses, and most of our travel was in wagons, sleighs, and just plain horseback. We had an old record player, then finally an old Atwater Kent radio, which was a real luxury to us. We used icicles from the house to make ice cream. Sometimes they were so long they reached the ground. I missed lots of school when I was a kid, because we lived 6 miles from town, and the weather was so cold and snowy my folks just wouldn't chance sending me. I remember going to the old silent movies for 10 cents. Wages for teenagers was 5 cents a day, and for grown-ups it was $1. We had an old outhouse outside that we had to use for a bathroom, and boy, did we ever hate to make that trip. The one close neighbors we had was my grandma and Aunt Edith, who lived across the street. At the age of 12, I got my own horse. I used to herd cows for my dad and loved horses. I had a scary experience or two with the horse. One of these was when I foolishly decided to take a shortcut home across the river. I always rode with no saddle. I just dug in my heels and clung onto the mane. When the horse got into the middle where it was deep, it panicked and began to jump around. Well, I just hung on, and we made it to the other side. Lucky me, 'cause I can't swim.